name is Gerhard Bormann. I'm a marine geologist, and for that specific lek, I'm the chief scientist. We started in Istanbul, the 2 hours through the Bosporus Strait, where you have this nice panorama on both sides of the channel, and then if you reach the entrance to the Black Sea, you really have a total impression because you see the large area of the Black Sea. There are many things which are very interesting for the Black Sea. There is really a large amount of methane. Methane is moving upwards in the sediments, forming hydrates close to the seafloor, and as well, methane is intruding into the water column. Gravity Cora is a simple tool, but we use it during all our expeditions to sample gas hydrate pieces from the seafloor. Methane hydrate is a solid component, like ice, composed of methane and water. We have large amounts of methane hydrates in the oceans. Those methane reservoirs we will use in the future for fuel, and also methane can move from the seafloor to the atmosphere, and then it has a potential as a greenhouse gas. We bring those samples back to the ship and store it in liquid nitrogen for crystallographic and chemical analysis of hydrates. We are investigating the Dvorachensky mud volcano since a couple of years. The mud volcano is filled up by mud up to the rim, and there is mud which flows over the rim down the flanks. And we have warm mud which comes in the center of the mud volcano to the surface. So I think Dvorachensky mud volcano is one of the most active mud volcanoes we know from the Black Sea. We use the Marum AUV seal to produce a very detailed map from the surface of the mud volcano. With a research vessel, we have a resolution of approximately 10 to 20 meters, but with the AUV, we are getting a resolution of 10, 20, 30 centimeters, which shows details which we really can see when we are with the ROV down on the seafloor. We could also see in that map a temperature mooring which we installed 3 years ago on the mud volcano, but on a different position. So we saw in the map that the position changed about 100 meters, which could only be explained by a transport of the mud. And we could then use our Marum ROV for bringing that mooring back to the ship. We could not only sample the data logger, which showed a record of 3 year temperature measurements, we could also bring the whole system back to the ship. The highlight really was that we had high sophisticated research tools on board with complicated handling, and it worked very well to combine those instruments, and it was quite impressive with this research vessel together that we got very good results.